Hey guys, what's going on? Spitbricks here, back for another LEGO Ninjago video, and in this video I'll be discussing what the symbols on the new ninjas for the Ninjago movie really might mean. This is going to be a really interesting video, so I highly recommend you guys stick around for the whole entire video and comment your guys' ideas down below. Now before I jump into the video, I do want to announce the winner of my $50 LEGO gift card giveaway. The giveaway did end, and here we have our winner is LEGO123 exclamation point. Here you can see I'm on his channel right now. You can see he loves LEGO Ninjago, obviously. He's got his subscriptions. Here I am right here. He has subscribed to me, as well as liked one of my videos. There's actually quite a few more in here as well, but you did only need to like one. But if you liked more, that's super awesome. LEGO123, congratulations. You have won the $50 LEGO gift card. I will give you a private message, and you can respond back with your email, and I can send you the code, or you can send me your address, and I will send the card to you. Now, if you didn't win, don't worry, because since you all loved my first giveaway, I will be giving away another $50 gift card. The rules are very simple. All you have to do, like this video, subscribe to my channel, and turn on notifications, and you will be entered to win. This giveaway will run for a few months, and the winner will be announced on a future video of mine, so be sure to stay active. Now, enjoy the video. Alright guys, so today I'm back for another LEGO Ninjago video, in which I will be exploring the meanings of these symbols on the ninjas' head robes. So, the ninjas have had a lot of different symbols over the years, and most of them have been very unique for themselves, not really meaning anything in typical life culture for us as humans. However, they do mean something for the ninja. But now with this LEGO Ninjago movie, their symbols, I guess you could say, have changed a little bit, and they have gotten to these symbols that you can see here, and this picture displays them even better. You can see the different markings, and they're all pretty unique. They don't all kind of have the same sort of shape. You can see that Nia's and Kai's are kind of rounded on the sides, and then you have Jay and Lloyd, who have really rigid, using like lines, and then you have Zane, which has a really interesting one. Now, I've been really curious about this, so I've been researching various variations of Chinese, Japanese, Korean, any sort of language like that that uses these symbols to kind of come across whether these mean anything. And based on my findings, these symbols are not apparent in any of the languages that we know of today. Which means that these symbols are actually unique to the ninja once again, or at least that's what we can infer. Now, these may be from an actual language, whether they mean, like for coal here, whether it means earth, or maybe it means coal. We don't really know, and why would they pick these symbols? Obviously, they're all really different, like I've said, and I guess you can't really say why they choose these symbols for the ninja. Now, this might be random, but some of it is kind of interesting. You can see that J's down on the bottom there is just two lines. That's the simplest one out of all these, other than Nia, which has just a little arc and a little thing on top of that, which kind of looks like a water droplet or in along like a river, which I thought was kind of interesting whenever I first looked at that. Just like how Zane's is very interesting as well. And this is one of the main reasons why I do not think these symbols are from an actual language, because of the fact that Zane's does not look like anything you'd see in the real world as a word or as a name. I don't really think that's actual thing, so I'm gonna have to say that LEGO has made these up for the specific ninja, because of course, well, if you look at that, kind of looks like a snowflake, doesn't it? And of course, Zane is kind of that frozen feel. He's of course the master of ice, but you know, snowflakes are technically frozen, sort of like ice, that sort of thing. So I guess that could tie in right there. We have all these other different symbols though that you can't really tie into much, and I think it's kind of interesting. You guys can leave your guys' thoughts down below on what you think each of these mean. Now, looking at Cole's as well as Lloyd's, I don't really see exactly where LEGO was going. I don't know if that's really supposed to mean anything. They're very random in my opinion, as are all these pretty much. Maybe in the movie we'll be able to figure out what these are, maybe they'll be able to tie into something, and maybe even Master Wu will know whenever he gives them their ninja suits. But until then, we can only guess. 1, 2, 3. And that's pretty much it. I mean, there isn't a defined answer, but if any of you guys know what the defined answer is, be sure to let me know down below in the comments. I know all the other LEGO Ninjago fans watching this video would love to know as well. Maybe do some research of your own trying to figure out what these ones are, and if anybody can figure out the exact one, I will include your comment in the next video of me explaining the differences and what each of them mean, if you allow me to do that. So I think that would be really cool. So that's pretty much it for this video. It was just a short little talk brief that I wanted to have with you guys, just to see if you guys know anything, and also to portray my research between this. So this is a really interesting topic. I've actually been really curious and been exploring this for the past couple days. And I think it would be really interesting if you guys would like to explore it as well, trying to figure out what these means. It's really cool. It's basically like you're being a detective in real life. And that's pretty much it for this video. I'm Spitbricks. If you guys are new, do not forget to hit that subscribe button and like this video if you are excited for the LEGO Ninjago movie. I certainly am. Very exciting. Coming out pretty soon in a few months. So that's going to be really awesome. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I'll see you guys next video coming very soon.